We are so glad you are with us today, whatever day it is, and whatever time of day. We hope that this service of the Holy Word may inspire you and preserve you. And we hope that you may visit us in person someday at the First Congregational Church in the heart of Gray Village in the great state of Maine. We wish you peace and good health, and remind you that whatever the circumstances, the presence of God and the communion of the saints is forever and ever. Please join me for the call to worship. O Lord, our Governor,
how exalted is your name in all of the world.
Out of the mouths of infants and children,
your majesty is praised above the heavens.
You have set up a stronghold against your adversaries
to quell the enemy and the avenger.
When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers,
the moon and the stars you have set in their courses,
what is man that you should be mindful of him?
The son of man that you should seek him out.
You have made him but little lower than the angels.
You adorn him with glory and honor.
You give him mastery over the works of your hands.
You put all things under his feet.
All sheep and oxen.
Even the wild beasts of the field.
The birds of the air, the fish of the sea.
And whatsoever walks in the paths of the sea.
O Lord, our Governor,
how exalted is your name in all the world.
Amen.
Good heavens sound up here.
Please let us know how we can pray for you. You may send prayer requests and your joys to the church email address, which is on our webpage and Facebook page. And do let us know if what you share may be mentioned during this broadcast or you would like it to be circulated on the prayer wheel of our church. We have many people who steadfastly pray for many people throughout the week. If you would like to include yourself or a loved one in that number, do let us know. Let us pray. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, in the beginning your Spirit moved upon the waters, and you have moved within us with every breath we take. And you have moved our hearts to come to this sacred place and give you thanks for our many blessings. No matter who you are or where you are, you warm us with your presence and light our paths with your word and counsel. We know, O Lord, that you are everywhere and that no matter where we are or who we are or how we are, your presence comes with us and that you warm our hearts with your spirit. We pray for the town of Gray, the county of Cumberland, and the state of Maine, especially for those who are sick in mind or body. We pray for those who are in the streets. We pray for those who are staying home. We pray for those who wear masks. We pray for those who do not wear them. We pray for law enforcement, for the fire department, for all public servants who keep us safe. We pray especially for those who have overstepped their bounds and have been too zealous in the prosecution of their duty. We pray for the victims of injustice, whether here or there, in this country or far abroad. We pray also, as we do every week, for Donald, our president, for Janet, our governor, Susan and Angus, our senators, Shelley, our member of Congress, Sue and Catherine, our representatives, and Augusta, members of our town council, and all who serve us in public office. May they serve us wisely and administer the laws with justice and mercy. We pray for our sister congregations in Gray, our sister congregations in the United Church of Christ, for Deborah, our conference ministers, for Thomas, the Episcopal Bishop of Maine, for Robert, the Roman Catholic Bishop of Portland, and all who lead churches in this time of crisis. In this time, as every time, Lord, give us the grace to appreciate differences and the courage to find the similarities. Give us grace to accept with serenity the things that cannot be changed, courage to change what should be changed, and the wisdom to distinguish one from the other. All these prayers we utter in the name of the great physician, even Jesus Christ our Lord, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
from Genesis chapter 1, verses 27 to chapter 2, verse 3. So God created humankind in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, and God said to them, "Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves upon the earth." God said, "See, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit, you shall have them for food. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has the breath of life, I have given every green plant for food." And it was so. God saw everything that he had made, and indeed it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all their multitude. And on the seventh day God finished the work that he had done. And he rested on the seventh day from all the work that he had done. So God blessed the seventh day and hallowed it, because on it God rested from all the work that he had done in creation.
Our gospel lesson for today is from the Gospel according to St. Matthew. This is how St. Matthew concludes his gospel. The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always, to the end of the age." And moving, how express and admirable action, how like an angel. In apprehension, how like a god. The beauty of the world, the paragon of animals. Yet, how easily is man? How easily are we, all of us, male and female, how easily are we laid low? There are now 100,000 Americans dead now who would be alive otherwise, were it not for a tiny thing we can't even see and is not even alive. We have all learned a lot about viruses in the past few months, but we still don't know for sure how they came about. One theory holds that they are the building blocks of all life on Earth. All of life has evolved from them. Another theory holds something quite different, that viruses have devolved from tiny microorganisms, which makes them, in a strange way, like fallen angels. They once had life and the ability to create life through reproduction, you might say the usual way, but they somehow decayed. Perhaps they rebelled or something. And now, like devils or vampires, have no life in themselves and must prey upon something living in order to reproduce. Whatever their origin, they do indeed function like devils or demons, or like the diabolically mindless Borg of the Star Trek series. Is this not strange? If we are so wonderfully made and so wonderfully capable, how come we are so vulnerable to disease? And so vulnerable to disease, both physical and spiritual? We have been struck this past week not just by our physical vulnerability, but by our moral vulnerability. How easily our bodies are torn apart by a virus, and how easily our body politic is torn apart by rage. As if we have not had enough heartbreak this spring, we now have to watch the rage on our city streets unfold after an incident that certainly could and should have been handled better. That it all started in Minneapolis, the city where I was born and partly grew up, is particularly heartbreaking for me. People make jokes about how nice people are in Minnesota. And that is what I remember. I remember growing up in a neighborhood where a vast network of parents watched over dozens of kids. We could walk and play all over the neighborhood, several square blocks, and do almost anything and go almost anywhere. Yet knowing that if we got hurt or did something really bad, a parent would immediately materialize. How shall we replenish ourselves this summer? As the scripture instructed our first parents after the first sin, as our hearts and bodies always yearn to do in the summer. How shall we replenish ourselves this summer? After yet another sin, after yet another lesson in patience and humility for fallen humanity. On this Communion Sunday, let us simply begin by remembering that we are, all of us, however fallen we are the body of Christ. Although we are not celebrating the sacrament of Holy Communion with our congregation, our full congregation present in the flesh, we are celebrating our communion with God and with one another. And when I say one another, I mean all of fallen humanity. By the sacrament we celebrate this morning, we are, all of us, the body of Christ. The God who was born in a stable, who trekked the dirty road from Bethlehem to Egypt and back, who grew in wisdom and strength in the presence of his parents, who kept vigil along the bedside of his dying father, his dying earthly father, Saint Joseph, who savored the delights of friendship with his disciples, whose heart was moved to compassion by the suffering of the hungry, the thirsty, and the sick, the one who endured all the evil that human beings might heap upon him as he carried the cross, who offered a tender goodbye to his mother and his disciples, the one who rose from the dead, ascended into heaven, and now sits fully human and fully divine. This one, Christ our Lord, has made this life of ours, this perilous and contingent life, forever and remarkably beautiful, has made us forever and remarkably one people. The sadness we now feel at being apart, the sadness we feel at the rage and division in our country, the sacrifice we make now truly is remarkably beautiful. We are one people. We are remarkably the body of Christ. Let us give thanks and celebrate Holy Eucharist. Amen. Amen. Please join me for the prayer of confession. Life swirls around us, O Lord. So many things are happening in our lives, in our country, and in the world that make us fearful. We are so easily overwhelmed by the magnitude of the problems and needs we see around us. Remind us again that you are with us, offering compassion, strength, courage, and hope. Help us to place our trust in you and enable us to be your partners in ministries of grace, peace, and justice in your world. Amen. Brothers and sisters in Christ, hear the good news of the gospel. By the wonderful life and ministry and death and resurrection of our Lord, our sins are forgiven. We look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the communion of the saints in life and glory everlasting. We invite all those who seek reconciliation in Christ to this table. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
And we lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord God.
It is good to give God thanks and praise.
Truly, it is a good, right, and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Almighty God, for you watch over the strangers and the needy, and you raise us from death to life. You sent your Son Jesus to seek us when we were lost, to open the eyes of the blind, lift up those who are bowed down, give food to the hungry, and set free the prisoners of sin and death. When the powers of death rose against your Son, you raised Jesus to new life, confirming him as the revelation of your grace. who reigns with you forever in justice, truth, and love. And so, with the church on earth and the church in heaven, we join our voices in their unending hymn of praise, saying, Holy,
holy, holy,
holy, holy God of love and majesty, whole universe speaks of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. On the night that he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took the bread, and he blessed it, and he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples and said, This is my body, which will be broken for you. And on the same night, he took the cup and blessed it, and showed it to his disciples and said, This is my blood, which will be shed for you. Whenever you drink of this blood and eat of this bread, you partake of my body and blood until the end of time. Let us pray. Almighty God, send your Holy Spirit upon these elements and upon this company, whether here and near, for there and far. May your Spirit restore us and refresh us through this sacrament. Raise us on this firm pathway to everlasting life. Fill us with courage to comfort our friends and carry the good news to all the ends of the earth. Amen.
Amen.
These are the gifts of God for the people of God. This is the body of Christ broken for you. Feed on him with love and thanksgiving. Let us pray. Lord God, we give you thanks that you have fed us with this banquet of your love. Keep us alert for signs of your presence in the world around us. Send us as healing oil and sheltering comfort to those in need. And make us bold in testifying to the light of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father and of the Son.